to Osho's Vijnana Bhairava, and the meditation number is 55. Just see it properly. At the point of sleep, everybody go to sleep, isn't it? We all go, everyone goes to sleep. At the point of sleep, exactly at the time, when the sleep has not come, the sleep has not come. You are in an awakened state and going in for sleeping state, that gap, and external wakefulness vanishes. External wakefulness means what? Your wakefulness is slowly, it is going on, you are going in for sleepy state. At this point, being is revealed. Revealed means what? It is shown out what you are. So, at the time of sleep, when you are going to sleep, when slowly your awakeness goes off, you are going to sleepy state, that gap is what you are. So, with this philosophy, we are going to start our meditation. Dear friends, what do you mean by consciousness? Consciousness. What do you mean by consciousness? Awareness, right? Okay. For example, a fellow without a single rupee, say for example, Dr. Abdul Kalam, right? He started his life as a paper man, right? Putting papers in each houses. He went up to the post of what? President of India. Right, sir. One of the gentlemen was there, Rajiv Gandhi. His mother is dead. Immediately he is appointed as the Prime Minister. Whose consciousness is more powerful? One Ambani, from nothing, zero, he went up to the level of being India's richest man. Mukesh Ambani, what Ambani is it? Thirubani Ambani. His awareness is more, or now the presenter, Mukesh Ambani's awareness is more. Whose awareness is more? Whose consciousness is more? Definitely it must be, no. Father Ambani, Dhirubhani Ambani. Because when you go in for stage by stage, your consciousness develops, right? So here, in this sutra, here it says, two points are there, very important points. What are the two points? When you are going to sleep, your wakefulness disappears and you are going to the sleepy state. That gap, it will be so atomic, it may be a minute, it may be a moment, it may be a second. That gap, and the morning time after sleeping and getting up, that gap, two points are there. In these two points, it is revealed, it is told who you are, what you are, if you are able to concentrate. Daily it is happening, only thing is we are not aware of that point. Daily morning to night, what you do? You see all type of things, right? All false or true things you are doing. Morning you see, come to the office, you meet the manager, you give a smile. Is the smile is a true smile or a put up smile? It's a not true smile, definitely not a true smile. You have an anger towards your wife, you just show your loving face. It is all facial, it's all acting. In the night time, is it true? Night time also it is a dream state. Night time you are something like a dead body and all type of dreams come. Even there you are not true. So where are you true? The true point is the point from the wakefulness to sleepy state, and from sleepy state to wakefulness state, that particular point, when you just analyze and find and go inside, there your true being is revealed. True being means what? The power inside you, the energy inside you. With that energy, you will be able to understand what life is all about. The confusion disappears. So here, my dear friends, in dreams, are the dreams true? See, from daytime, morning to night, you are in awakened state, isn't it? You are awakened, you know everything, what's happening. What are dreams first? Could anybody say what are dreams? What is a dream? Dream is something in the daytime when some your wishes are not fulfilled. Those wishes come in the night as symbols, right? That's what psychoanalysis. See, the gentleman wants to go to Australia. And here they are, they want to go to US. It's all Western countries. What happens mostly? Everything are material oriented. World is material oriented, dollar oriented, money oriented. In India also is changing, city life is changing, but in villages we have that attachment, so called that feelings called love and love and affection, everything is still there. But in cities and Western countries, what you find is highly materialistic. So morning time, whatever you see and whatever you desire to have, night time it is comes out, not in exact terms, it will come out in symbols. That's what they say. In dream, you go to psychiatrist. You know, in Chennai, it is very difficult to get an appointment from a psychiatrist. Everybody are busy, everybody are fixed. Mentally, people are stressed out. In US, it is a very good occupation, psychiatrist. So, when you go to a psychiatrist for some problem, he'll be asking, what are your dreams? What your dreams say? What do you see in the dreams? In the dreams, according to the dreams, what you see, they say what they interpret and say what your behavior is. See, a fellow is always a romantic fellow. What romantic you mean? Always in love, okay? What do you call him as? What do you call him as? A fellow who is always with a lot of girls and fun. Debunchi. A fellow who is always in a, with the females and with the males or females with the males. So, they are called debunchi. He will never have a dream of sex in his dream. He will never feel that. But a saint, so called all the saints and all the priests, when they suppress their feelings, they will get the dreams of sexual dreams. When you suppress your hunger in the daytime, in night, you will get a symbol of some mangoes or apples or chicken biryani or mutton biryani, whatever it is. When you suppress something, that comes out in the dream. When you suppress sex, it comes in the dream. I can tell you 100% of all the saints and priests who suppress in the dreams, their feelings comes in symbols. So here, both the day when you are in awakened state, it is a false. You are not living true to what you are. In the night time also, you are not living true to what you are. Both are actions. For money and needs and everything, morning to night you put a makeup. Your face is something different. Not original face. You laugh, but it is not rooted. There is no root. You cry, even that cry is not a true cry. You want something, for that you are crying. So at that particular moment, see, in Tibetan, you know Zen monasteries? Have you heard about Zen monasteries? Whenever you go there, the first training is, they will tell you, a disciple comes to the master, the first training is, he has to close his eyes. He has to feel that he is falling deep in a dark well. Everything is dark. So he has to keep on falling. There is no place, there is bottomless. You keep on going inside. As you keep on going inside, what will happen? Close your eyes, you keep falling. Down. Bottomless, endless. So, that's what in Buddha, in Zen, this philosophy is there. Endless, that's called, it is called Nirvana. Once you understand the endless inside you, that is in the gaps, in the two gaps. In the two gaps is like, you know, two mountains, the peaks are there. Mountain peaks. What are the peaks? These peaks are the waking stage and sleeping stage. Waking stage and sleeping stage. Sleeping stage and waking stage. In between the gap is abyss. Abyss means what? A-B-Y-S-S. Depth. It goes inside. It is a weird phenomena. What do you mean by weird? W-E-A-R-D. Weird phenomena. It is something holistic, fatalist, something magic oriented. So that gap, even though it is a fraction of second, in that second, if you concentrate, you understand your being. What is your being? See, you might have seen many people are born and dead, isn't it? Where are they? As they were living, they were telling, I am this and that. So powerful. Where are they now? Where is Saddam Hussein? Where is our, ex-chief minister Imtiaz or Veerappan? They talk so much. But the true being, true, the authentic power, the talent, everything is found in the time of the waking stage. You go to the bed today, darken your room. Mind you, only if dark you can sleep. Dark is the mother of all colors. From the dark only all the colors have come. Dark is the mother of all colors. In the dark, you go to bed, lie down in the bed. Mind you, if you have thoughts, negative thoughts keep multiplying and it won't make you to sleep, isn't it? Have you noticed that? One thought comes, granddaughter thought comes, all multiplies. As it multiplies, you won't be able to sleep. But just lie down without thinking. Just close your eyes. Just feel the body. The body will feel light, heavier. You know, when you go to bed, you put off the lights, full dark, the body will feel heavier. As you sleep, what happens? There'll be a moment when almost everything is over. Awakened state is over. Sleeping state starts in. That gap, if you are able to concentrate, it takes some time. But once if you concentrate on that gap, then you have achieved what you are. So, mother, father, teacher, God, is it ordered, isn't it? Who is the best person in the world? Mother. Who is the second person best in the world? Third?
Teacher.
Fourth? These are the four worst fellows for everybody, you know that? Mother is the worst person, everybody wants to kill her, you know that? Father is the second person everybody wants to kill. Teacher is the worst fellow everybody wants to kill. And finally, God, they want to kill him first if they see him. Why? Why is it so? Mother is greatest enemy in this world, inimical. She is the worst person according to a person. That's what every religion, Hinduism or Christianity or Islam, every religion says, worship your mother. Mother is the greatest God. See, when you are in the mother's womb, you are so natural. You are in that center point. Then after you come in the world, what happens? When you cry, your mother is the first teacher. She teaches you. There is a connection, relationship between your mother and you. First teacher. When you cry, you see your face. When you don't know the language at all, you see your mother's face. According to mother, when you laugh, mother gives you some gift. She laughs, hugs, gives you milk, everything. When she doesn't like something, either she scolds or gives two taps or pinches. So, this a new politician is born. What politician is born? A cunning fellow is born. So, he makes up a laugh. He sometimes cries for something. Have you seen the children? They keep on crying to get something, acting. So, the mother is not allowing his true self of the son. So, she is the first person. So, whatever in future, whatever happens, wrong happens, you put the blame on mother. The society puts the blame on mother. A boy is good or bad according to the brought up of mother. They put the blame on mother. So, inimically inside his heart, the first person for all his sorrows, it is because of his mother. Second person, father. He is the